Swings it to Ty Kellis, other wing. Off back iron, rebound McCoy. McCoy gets blocked. Gets his own rebound back to Liddell. Miscommunication, but Liddell gets it back. Liddell driving in. Snatchback jumper, bang. Liddell gets the midi for Nixon. As Carl Drencher pushes up the court the other side, guarded by Meisner. Meisner gets a steal. And can't save it. Stay Carl Junction ball. Passing comes in for Colt McCoy. He's in a bit of foul trouble with his two fouls. First quarter. Passing Carl Junction finds Anderson, top of the key, driving on Kellis. Can't get the layup. Rebound by Hassan. Hassan pushes it up to Jackson. Jackson driving in. Drives with the right hand layup. Can't get it to connect. Push up the court shorter. One, driving in. Gets a contact layup on Ty Kellis. Carson Anderson with the finish.
Both teams working good in trenches in this game.
Jackson gets the ball back. Yeah, both teams pushing up the court, moving fast offenses, trying to get easy points. Liddell. And a screen from Hassan. Shoots a three-pointer. Can't get it to go. Rebound Kellis. Back to Jalen, slows it down. Jackson, right wing, driving in. Swings across to Kellis. Kellis, three-pointer. Good. Second of the game for Kellis. He's up to 6 points. Colby Martin, just to Andrews. That'll be shorter. Kellis, the steal for Nixa, bringing up the court. Finds Jackson. Jackson, jab step, driving in. Feed to Meisner through his legs by Anderson. Anderson pushing up the court. Finds shorter, short of the corner. Three-pointer off front iron. Around Meisner. Liddell pushing up in transition for the Eagles. Ty Kellis, right wing, pump fake. Three-pointer off back rim. Anderson pushing up for Carl Junction. Euro step, fade away, blocked by Hassan.
Knicks' defense here is really getting the best of Carl Junction.
Yeah, they're not getting able to get a lot of shots off. Now, the ones they do shoot do go in, tend to, high percentage shots tend to go in, but three-pointers aren't falling. Hassan inside for Meisner. Hassan was open, didn't like a shot apparently.
Both teams with a lot of turnovers just early.
Anderson looking inside, kicks to the corner, three-pointer. Off again for Carl Junction. Can't seem to get a three to go. Jackson pushing up for Nixa. It's Hassan. Hassan, baseline. Drives in. Right hand layup, and he finishes it. Drives baseline, gets the contact layup. 14-4 is your score. Carl Junction on the attack. Drives in on Nixa. Contact layup. Liddell pushing up. Kellis, left corner. Three-pointer. Short. Rebounded by Swarns. Swarns pushing up the court. Loses control. It'll be Knicks a ball.
Knicks' fast-paced play has gotten a lot of good opportunities for Knicks. They just need to get more to fall.
Yeah. And Carl Junction getting the open shots, just not being able to finish. Three-pointers aren't falling. We should attack more, try to go to the three-point line. Free throw line. Oh, from the corner, inside to Hassan. Hassan, pump fake, and banks it in off the glass. At a two-point mid-range. Hey, good to go, guarding him full court. Shorter, feet inside, good pass, and gets the foul. Can't get it to finish, but like I said, Carl Junction needing to feed inside, go to the free throw line, get these easy points. And that's exactly what they do.
Carl Junction hoping that these fall to get their offense going.
Get some momentum. It'll be Parker Dodds at the line. 15. First one's off the front line. Colt McCoy comes back in for, he's been on fire this game. Ty Kellis. His two threes already. Playing good basketball for Nixa. Chew. Missed it short again. Tipped off Carl Junction. Nicks the ball.
Both of those free throws needed to go in for Carl Junction, hopefully to spring their offense, but
couldn't get them to fall. He used a little bit more legs. He was short on both them. One hand grasp. We'll stay next to the ball. After Oaf looking for the baseball pass down to the other end. Can't get it to connect. It was a good thought. Hassan driving in. Left hand. Going in. Shoots it. Off back. Rebounded shorter. Shorter. Pushing up in transition. Shorter. Wide open layup. And Colt McCoy beats it off the backboard. Is Owen Sides in transition. Gets fouled.
From what we've seen early in this game, Knicks' off-ball movement has spurred a lot of opportunities for them.
Yeah, their off-ball movement, cutting, screens, they're also getting open corner threes off. Also a great defensive effort by Colt McCoy on the other end to get rid of that layup that Carl Junction was about to have. It's Owen Sides, 15-foot jumper, banks it in.
Good, Owen Sides.
Shorter, taking up for Carl Junction. Guarded by Sides, closely at half court. Anderson, guarded by Oaf. Pass him, drives in. Feed to inside, and the finish from Parker Dodds. Great feed inside to Parker Dodds, and he finishes it. 18-6, with 12 seconds left. He's still trying to get final shot. Hassan driving in, feeds it to McCoy. Wide open layup. Great feed from Hassan. Right into McCoy. Two. And Carl Junction can't get the shot off. Your score after the first period is 20-6 in Knicks' favor. We'll be back after this break. We are back at the start of the second period. Knicks is up 20-6 on Carl Junction to get the ball to start the quarter. I just saw on the replay, again, that great defensive effort from Colt McCoy. Block it off the backboard. Owen Sides bringing up the ball. Sides, Street, three-pointer, bullseye. Nathan Brewer with a three-pointer for Knicks. Is Carl Junction pushing it back? Gets the and one on Colt McCoy. Colt McCoy up to three fouls now. A bit of early foul trouble. That's not what you want. Okay. Especially to be such a big contributor to this Knicks team. To get three fouls early is not helpful. Free throw won't go. Rebound Dodds, and he gets it. The putback. Layup from Dodds. Nathan Brewer bringing up the ball for Nixa. It's Kellis right wing. Kellis pump fake. Picks it up. Brewer back to the top of the key. On Sites, left wing. Sites, jab step. For Brewer. Brewer feeds it inside to Oaf. Oaf, mid-range jumper off the front iron. Rebounded by Anderson. Anderson shakes Owen Sites. Comes back to him. Bring it up, and they get the travel. A little bit of a stutter step before that pass.
Carl Junction early in the second quarter looking for more high percentage shots.
taking better ones too. Like they got that and one layup. Three pointers aren't falling. Maybe try to get some inside buckets. Kellis, off in the corner. Oh, three pointer. The back rim. Rebound McCoy. McCoy pump fake. And one McCoy for Knicks up. That'll propel the score 25-10. I was going to hope to tack on one more and make it a 16-point lead for Knicks up. Baylor Funk will come in for Carl Junction. Boy at the line. Boy gets the first one. Stolen by Nathan Brewer. Retrieved by Carl Junction. Carl Junction. Jump. 3-point. Funk. No pump fake. And some thoughts at the top of the key. Guarded by Kellis. Sizing up Kellis. Taking him to the rim. Back retreats to the corner. Looking for anyone. Find Shorter. Shorter. Guarded by Brewer. Shorter. Left hand drives in. Ball stolen, but they call a foul. That will be called on Nathan Brewer, his first, team second. Shorter passing it in. Dodds kicks back to Shorter, three-pointer off the back rim, rebounded by Oaf pushing up the court. Brewer, three-pointer. Well, look, it's Colt McCoy. Oaf cutting, gets it back to McCoy. Sights, catches it, and they got the travel. Picked up his pivot foot right as he caught it, came back down. Tough break for Knicks, so that might have been a three-pointer for him.
Right now, both teams need to slow it down, stop turning it over.
Agree, both teams getting a lot of turnovers. Just swinging around, get that defense moving, get an open shot. Funk, guarded by Oaf. Zero guarding zero. Corner, driving in. Back to Shorter, pump fake. Anderson driving on Kellis and gets it in right over Kellis. Kellis trying to come in from behind. Maybe get a chase down block. But Carson Anderson does not care. Finishes it anyway. Colt McCoy, reverse layup. Gets it the drop.
Colt McCoy already with 11 points in this game.
Yeah, McCoy playing really aggressive. Even with those three fouls, doesn't shine away from anything. Anderson. Shorter guarded closely, fights Anderson at the top of the key, guarded by Brewer. Anderson trying to mix up Brewer. Brewer gets the steal. Layup. And high off the glass, gets the drop. The Carl Junction pushing it the other way. They get trapped. Oaf backs off, goes back up for it. They'll find Funk, short corner. Funk. And as he passes, tries to go for the foul on the shot, call it on the floor.
Now even with the subs and Colt's three fouls, we'll see him stay on the floor here.
And with 4 minutes left in the second period, score is 30-12. Carl Junction passing the ball back in. Anderson looking inside. This is poked away by McCoy. McCoy finds Jackson in the backcourt. Jackson pushing it up to Liddell, left wing. Liddell pump fake. Meisner looking for the ball. Triton Jackson in the corner. Gets the ball tipped. And it'll be Funk the other way. Funk gets the ball and gets the wide open layup. I wouldn't say wide open, but he had some space right over Jackson. Be Liddell getting trapped at midcourt as Meisner, mid-range jumper off the right iron. Rebound Hassan. Hassan gets blocked, gets his own rebound, puts it back up on the left side. Be to Funk driving in. Dribble. Colby Martin. Gets his foul called. Be two shots for Colby Martin. Look at the replay. Yep, Meisner moving that arm down, getting the foul on him. makes the first as Ty Kellis will come back in. Colt McCoy.
And as Colt McCoy comes out here, we'll see if he sits the rest of the half.
And trying to conserve him from getting those fouls. He is a main source of points for Nixa, too. Run 11-13. Big part in their offense.
Yeah, if Nixa were to lose Colt in the early stages of the game, you just wonder if they could do as much as they have so far.
And Funk drives in, high off the glass, banks it in. And Coach Boyce wants a timeout. Timeout Eagles scores 32-17, 2:45 left in the second period. Carl Junction edging back into this lead. We'll be right back after this break, brought to you by Scooter's Coffee. We are back from the Nixa timeout. Nixa, Carl Junction going on a run. Nixa calling the timeout, maybe slow it down, get rid of their momentum, get back into this game. Only up by 15 now. Liddell drives in. It's the up and under layup to go. The circus shot from Jalen Liddell. As it falls, Carl Junction will be pushing up. Liddell guarding heavily. Carl Junction finds Funk in the corner. Funk. Finds Tent, three-pointer off back iron, rebound Brewer. Brewer, the middle of the floor, pulls it down, drives in, finds Seitz, right corner, Seitz, pump fake, pull up, won't go. Rebound Funk, Funk pushing it the other way. Funk goes in on Seitz, and gets it to drop. Rattles around the rim, it goes in. Seitz, left-hand layup, right off the glass. Great take from Owen Seitz. As these teams are just going back and forth with the points. Colby Martin gets loose ball. Gives it to corner to Funk. Funk up to Craig Hayes. Craig Hayes throws it in what may? No, won't go back court, saves it. Cross court pass to Martin. Back to Funk at the top of the key, guarded by Oaf, driving on Oaf. Bumps him, kicks it back out. Jabstep drives in. Floater off the front iron. Gets his own rebound. Kicks it out to Anderson. Anderson guarded heavily by Liddell. Pokes it free, gets it back. Gets it out. Pump fake, Euro step. Gets it right off the glass. A great move from Jet Mills getting the Euro step finish. But Brewer, other end, three-pointer. Off the iron. Jet Mills tries for the Euro step again and loses it. Liddell going for the charge, doesn't get it. It will be Eagles ball nevertheless.
Right now, CJ's trying to scramble and get something to go for them, but they just can't get it right now.
Yeah, but in that half-court offense, except got players playing aggressive, driving in, getting these points. This Knicks lead, now they just got to get down, guard on the other end. Liddell drives in. Hassan, fadeaway. Rebound by Jackson. Jackson gets fouled on the putback. Shots for Jackson. Look at the replay. Gets right on the head. Jackson at the line. First one rattles in. It leads 16-17. Does. Carl Junction wants the full timeout. Talk it over. They were on a run there, getting into this lead. But Nixa responds, gets some points their way, and Now it's a 17-point game. 30 seconds left in the second quarter. We'll be right back after this break. Back from the Carl Junction timeout with a little under 30 seconds left. The Carl Junction ball. Jet Mills bringing it up for Carl Junction. Guarded full court by Liddell. Colby Martin back to Jet Mills. Gets a step on Liddell. Right hand layup. Can't finish right off the front rim. Makes us slowing it down.
It appeared that CJ was going to try and go for the 2-for-1 there.
Yeah. Makes it. 9 seconds left, Liddell with the ball, got it closely by Mills. Jackson, 5 seconds left. Spin move, falls over. Stolen by Carl Junction. Anderson looks up court. Not a great way to finish the half from both ends. Both teams, both ended with turnovers, but that's the first half from this Knicks versus Carl Junction JV matchup. Your score is 38-21, and we'll be back in 10 minutes.
Hey Dads, Kevin Kopp here, and we're inviting you to the first ever All-District All-Pro Dads Breakfast. This is a breakfast where we want you to bring your kids so that you can spend some bonding time with them and hear an encouraging message on courage. Kick off your new year right by spending time with your kids at our first ever All-District All-Pro Dads Breakfast. We're gonna have some special guests there, our very own heroes of NICSA, NICSA Fire and NICSA Police, so you don't wanna miss it. I'm here with Corey Johnson, one of our heroes of NICSA.
Hey guys.
You wanna come out and check it out, hang out with those guys. Also, we'll have some cool police and fire vehicles there. So come on out January 13th, 8 a.m. to the Fought Administration Center Community Room.
When I was a child, I remember my teacher asking me, what do you want to be when you grow up? And I said, I want to be a teacher or a nurse. I think if we instill these things in our kids, even at the age of 7 and 8 years old, they're like, hey, I love what the firefighter's doing. I want to be a hero.
And it helps them to have more appreciation for their community, because I think they hear about community helpers even all the way from kindergarten, but actually seeing them and meeting them in person and hearing directly from that source is a much bigger difference and impact.
Now, I've been with NICSA 9 years, and I mean, we do this every year, almost all the elementary schools, everything. We get in there and visit. The message is always the same. You know, we want you to be safe and keep your friends and family and neighbors safe.
Get down whenever there's a fire and get out. He said, whenever your clothes is on fire, you should stop, drop, and roll.
For the kids to see the mayor, you know, they looked at him as a presidential candidate, and he was a big deal. And a lot of them were coming back to our classroom and saying, you know, I would like to be a mayor, or I'd like to be the president someday. And for them to understand that there are different positions besides a firefighter and a librarian, that helps run our community.
And I don't think they really hear about that role as much in school. We're just very used to talking about those who go and save lives, which is definitely needing to be talked about. But I don't think we really talk about our roles in the government as much with kids.
We like for the kids and their parents to have a plan. If an incident does happen in their home, for those kids to have a meeting place, know where they're going, and that way parents can get there and have an accountability of those kids so they can let us know as we come up that, you know, we have everybody, everybody's out. Having two ways out of your room, you know, more than one exit, the front end one is, don't mess with that stuff to begin with. Be cautious, help your parents, you know, your parents get busy and forget there's a candle burning.
You know, I think that's what it takes, is the community to get involved in the schools and the schools to get involved in the communities, and that's what makes us one big happy family. And so that's what I felt like on Community Day, is that we were one big happy family working together.
It's like they just look up to you going in, and they know your name, and they ask you questions, ask you permission to do things. It almost feels like rewarding, and like you're making an impact on these kids' lives, and it's a great feeling.
Kids really need to know that your food just doesn't show up. There's so much time and effort that farmers put into it for it to be there, and so you're able to be healthy and get the nutrition that you need.
I think they're doing amazing. I was here the first week, and then I just pop in randomly, and I kind of let them take charge. These three, and there's 3 to 4 others that kind of help teach when they can, but they help prepare the lessons. I kind of store the stuff, and they tell me what they need if they need supplies, but they are in charge of doing all the lessons.
Our first lesson was a little rocky and rough, but I can definitely tell a difference on like how much we've improved with like teaching and explaining things. We had an Agate on the Move training day, so we went to OTC, and they like went through the lessons with us as if we were the third graders that they were teaching, and it just really gave us like an idea of how to teach the lessons and like all the things that we needed to include in them, and like things that might be confusing to the kids, and we made sure to explain those when we were doing our lessons.
What really opened my eyes is we did a petting zoo at Nixa Sucker Days, and we had so many kids think that our cow was a bison, or that even adults thinking that the donkey was a horse, and we're like, we need to bring something back. And last year we did do some lessons, but we didn't have a program. We did it with the XLT kids. And so this year, having this program really helps have a curriculum and teach them more than we ever could last year.
I've even been walking through the grocery store, and they've been out of milk, and I've heard people say, well, why can't you just go to the back and just get more? So people don't truly understand where, and I think it's our job as agriculturalists to spread the positive message and to educate. So we hope that we're only teaching these, but they'll go home and share the lessons that they learned at home so that we can help to educate all the consumers. We would definitely like to thank Matthews and Mrs. Quackenbush for allowing us to be here.
I used to think like Native Americans were from the past, but now I like know they're still here.
Typically, you know, teaching for 11 years, teaching Native Americans every single year, kids think about them as they're just in the past. So I wanted them to be given the opportunity to see, no, this is still relevant. Like, these are still people who function just like we do in society, but they have a different culture, just like different kids in the class have different cultures. I have a different culture, and we do different things, and just exposing them to that, different worldviews, so that they get experience with that. Most kids don't love history, and as a teacher, I want to change that. So getting people to come in and talk to them and getting them to share artifacts and make it more real for them is my goal as a teacher.
Them coming helped us learn about it physically, not just mentally. We learned about it mentally and physically by them telling us and showing us. That helped it a lot more.
It was really good, and I really liked the dance that she did. That was cool.
All of of the dances that different cultures have different meanings, and so they got to see, I think they called it a jingle dance, and the whole dress, they moved in a specific way, and he played the drum, and it was neat to be able to see and hear about the story behind what that was for, how it was for healing, and how it stemmed from one of their own family members. So that was really neat to hear the history behind the dance. So they were really interested in the artifacts that they shared, and they were excited to be able to touch them, especially the buffalo hide, seeing how that the big hump that he talked about was on there. And it was just neat that they got to see and feel and touch all those different things.
I like buffalo fur because when we went to Yellowstone, a buffalo tried to stick its head in my window, and I wanted to feel it, but my dad drove away.
Bringing the outside in to the classroom so that kids know that, hey, what we're learning here, it goes on all over the world, and it's not just because you're in school. And so getting them to think sort of outside the walls is important.
And we are just 45 seconds away from the second half of this Nixa versus Carl Junction junior varsity game. Score is 38-21. Nixa leading by 17. And Nixa, Carl Junction, both having problems with the turnovers. Am I right?
Yeah, story of this game is the pace and the physicality.
Yeah, but the pace and physicality of the transitions can also lead to turnovers. Nixa may be lucky to have this big of a lead by how much they're giving up. Carl Junction, can you know maybe start knocking down shots, get into the line, the free throw line more, getting these wide open layups that they've been getting? I mean, I could see it being a close game. They just got to get back into it, and it'll be a good game. But Nixa leading by 17 right now, dominating. It may seem like, but here we are. Carl Junction ball coming off the half. Will be Maddox Shorter, number 5, passing it in. And Carson Anderson, the freshman guard, taking it down for the Bulldogs. Anderson at the top of the key. Half step driving in. Finds him in the corner. Right. Shorter, guarded by Liddell. Back to Hayes. Hayes, closely by Jackson. Anderson going in on Kellis. Spin move, and just off the back rim, rattles around and rims out. Liddell looks up for Jackson right over Kellis' head. Well, it looked like it could have been a disaster, but Liddell getting the screen from Meisner, hands it off to Jackson. Jackson and drive it in. Huge screen from Meisner. Kellis next down, next up to Liddell. Nixa seems to be going with the high ball screen as Liddell misses it off the front iron. And Colt McCoy puts it back. But Nix's offense looking for that high ball screen. And don't get it, just kick it back out. Rinse and repeat. Carl Junction pushing in transition. Hayes gets it stolen by Jackson. Meisner on the floor. Jackson keeps it. Eurostep back into McCoy. McCoy reverse layup. Man.
And this is exactly who Nix's needed. We didn't see McCoy for almost the last 5 minutes of the first half.
Yeah, McCoy in a bit of foul trouble with the... Ty Kellis gets that one to go. But McCoy in foul trouble with 3, I think. And he's a huge contributor to these points Nixa has. As it will be Swearin's on the other end for Carl Junction. Yeah, Nixa needs to keep up what they're doing. Carl Junction scoring a lot too, though. Both teams just need to help on the defense. McCoy, another bucket, spin move, showing off the post work.
McCoy already with 17 points.
Yeah. Will be Anderson. Wing gets poked away. Ripped by Triton Jackson. Triton Jackson taking in on Anderson. Gets the easy finish. Nixa took a long time to come out of that halftime. Came out with only about a minute left, but came out firing on all cylinders. As it will be Shorter missing from the corner. Liddell bringing it up slowly, changing the tempo. Jackson pump fakes the corner, drives in, into McCoy. McCoy continues his scoring 19th point. Mihez on the other side.
Both teams early on in this half have looked a lot more in sync.
A great pass from Hayes to Smarans for the wide open layup. Been a rare occurring thing in the start of this third quarter for the Eagles. Triton Jackson gets him to jump, can't finish the layup. They put a little bit of weird spin on it. Kellis, three-pointer, trifecta, and it falls. Nixa built on their lead. That was 117. Now is around 20-something. But Liddell pushed up the court. I can't do that math that fast. Gets it poked away. And it'll be tipped by Carl Johnson out of bounds. As Nixa building up this comfortable lead at the half. Will be subbing in most of their bench. All of their bench, actually. Nixa with the 28-point lead. Couldn't the math fast enough last time, but now 28-point lead with a little bit 3:30 left in the third quarter. Liddell gets it back at the top of the key for Seitz. Coming off the screen. Seitz back out. Hesitation. Spin move. Gets it ripped. It'll be Carl Junction pushing up as a foul is called. Transition. It'll be Bulldogs ball. Inbounding it from their bench. It's Hayes in the corner. Hayes drives it. Finds it. Back to top of the key of Anderson. Anderson driving it on Oaf. Goes in and gets it off the back iron. Bounces in. Strong take. Miladell the other way. In the corner, it's Hassan. And he gets it to go. Three-pointer for Gage Hassan. Carl Junction pushing it up. One and a three of their own. And from downtown, and he hits it. Austin Swearens. Nixon, Carl Junction trading threes. Going to transition. Nixon pushing it back up, slows it down, and Seitz on the right wing. Seitz gets the hesitation cross, pulls up, misses, and it'll be a loose ball. Still will be Carl Junction ball. No one really knowing who it might have tipped it. No one going for it, but ultimately Carl Junction ball. We're seeing a lot of transition points. DK, a lot of scoring for both ends. But yeah. Nixon built up that big lead at the start of the half. Carl Junction. It's crucial for them to try to come back.
Both teams still trying to push the pace, run offense early.
Feeds it inside. Dodds, just stealing by Brewer. Brewer pushing up for Nixa. Behind the back. Cross. Go, reverse layup, left hand. And it hits the shot clock. And it'll be out of bounds. Carl Junction ball. Triton Jackson coming back in for Nixa.
You have Nixa's points here have come from the first 10 to 15 seconds of their possessions.
Yeah, and there's transition points too. They're playing good defense, which rewards them with that. And finally hits Funk in the corner. He was wide open for about maybe 6 seconds. Weren't looking at him. Well, gets it back in the corner. For Hayes, deep three-pointer, and it is short and to the right. Maybe a bit of a bad shot if you're trying to come back. I mean, that was a deep three from almost volleyball line, so I don't know if the coach is liking that shot, but nicks the ball. Brewer, it's a screen from Jackson driving in. He's all over it. Craig Hayes with the defense. Brewer. Digging in, finds Seitz in the corner. Seitz, trying to look baseline. Won't go. Jackson at the top of the key to Oaf. Oaf driving in, gets the layup, and he finishes. The 2-point Beckett for Nixa. Lee is back to 28. little under a minute left in your third period. Be shorter on the left wing. Nixa looks like in this 2-3 zone. Carl Junction maybe looking for the weak spots. As they swing it across the shorter mid-range jumper off. And it'll be Seitz pushing it back the other way. 35 seconds left. Slows it down, looking for the last shot possibly. Seconds left, it goes into the hands of Jackson. Jackson, sizing him up, finds Hassan. Slot coming up to the top of the key. Seitz. It will be Seitz with 18 seconds left. Back to Jackson. Jackson dribbling in, spin move, up and under. Great finish from Jackson. The circus layup gets it to go. Great strong finish right off the hands. And Carl Junction three-pointer off the front rim. But man, what a finish from Triton Jackson. Gets past his man, spin move, up and under, soft touch. Gets the spin on the ball too, right off the glass and banks it in. And that's the end of your third quarter. Your score is 60-30. And we'll be back right after this break. We are back from this, from that break, start of the fourth quarter, 60-30. This is your score. Issa in favor. Hassan, we bring it in. Gets the finish off the front rim. It'll be Funk pushing up the court for CJ. Funk, floater, off. Rebound, Oaf. Oaf slows it down, looking for Brewer. Brewer, only man his way shorter. Pulls it back, setting up the offense. Oaf driving in, kicks it to Seitz. Seitz, left corner, off back rim.
Right now in these early possessions, we'll see what the fourth quarter holds for both teams, see if Nixa tries to hold the ball or extend their lead. TJ obviously trying to push back.
Seitz will get the foul called on him with Anderson. Seitz didn't look happy about that foul call, maybe thought he got all ball, but they call it, sitting at the line. First one hits the back rim and falls.
Right now the clock is on Nix's side. It is a running clock because of their lead. CJ needs to push back to get this clock to stop more often.
Makes the second free throw, and there it is. The clock stops now. 3-point lead goes away, only by one, but at least it stops. Trent Jackson drives in and loses the ball. May have been tipped. Say it will. Remain Nixa ball. Oaf passing it in for Nixa. For Seitz coming around the corner. Brewer wide open left wing. Trey ball off the front rim. Will be shorter pushing up for Carl Junction. Shorter feet inside. Stolen by Brewer. Brewer pushing it up. Seitz left corner downtown. Won't go. Rebound Dodds. Finds hands a shorter. Shorter looks to the corner. Back. Jab step drive. Picks it up. Shot from Colby Martin. Goes. Three-pointer from Colby Martin. Cuts into this lead even more. Triton Jackson looking inside for Brewer. Brewer back outside to Jackson. Jackson driving in. Out to Seitz. Seitz, three-pointer. And gets it the ball. Goes around the rim. Somehow gets it to fall.
Right now, both teams looking to stretch the floor as much as they can.
Stretch the floor. Carl Junction going against the zone. Look for the holes, which may be middle, the short corner. Lose the ball right there. It's been miscues like that the whole game. It's why they're down by this substantial amount. The turnovers, the loose balls, the sad, just not ball handling, losing them the game. Meisner, turnaway jumper, fadeaway jumper, rebound, Oaf, and Oaf gets the reverse layup.
Now, unless CJ scores here, it will be a running clock as Knicks is up 31.
Call a foul on Knicks. That one's on Nathan Brewer, his third foul of the game. And you know, McCoy, great score for Knicks. So we haven't seen him in a while. Maybe it's just they built this lead, don't want to get him hurt. That'll be Jack Maddox Shorter hitting that three for Carl Junction. But he hasn't been in the game in a while. Been a huge source of points for Knicks. But this lead that they have, you know, maybe there's no reason. Meisner, pump fake, floater, off front rim, gets his own rebound. No look pass to Jackson. Jackson driving in, gets fouled at the rim. Hard foul, he goes to the floor. Going to the line for two. 3:24 left in this fourth quarter.
All right, now it's just really Knicks are trying to keep this lead at a healthy pace and then soon take out their starters.
Like I mentioned, Kellis over there too. With Jackson misses both of them. It'll be Shorter pushing it up for Carl Junction. Side gets it back. Anderson off the backboard, back rim. Brewer pushing up the ball for Nixa. Brewer finds Seitz. Seitz going off the screen. Tween, Hezzy looking in. Kicks to Oaf, three-pointer. Rolls in.
It's good, Grady Oaf.
Grady Oaf with another three for Nixa. Hoping to build on this lead, get out of this game quicker. It will be Ryan Landolt, top of the key. Landolt going back and forth with Colby Martin, right back to him. Landolt feeds it inside. Dodds off front rim. Rebound Shorter. Shorter, step back. Looked inside, stolen by Oaf. Brewer pushing it up. Right hand layup is good. And ref calls the time. Passing kick going for Jackson. And it will be a full timeout for the Bulldogs. Your score is 70-37, 2:06 left in the fourth. We'll be back right after this timeout.
Welcome back to
Anderson, Shorter, left wing. Shorter. And they do see the weak side of the zone, which is the middle. They keep feeding it, but can't get anything out of it. From three, bullseye, Colby Martin. Three-pointer goes. 74-40 now. Meisner drives in, left hand, floater, and one. You can count it. One shot for Matthew Meisner going for the and one play. Knicks has gone to the line a lot this game, hitting a lot of them too. that one. Maybe jinx them. Meisner gets his own rebound floater. He's good.
Nixon is able to push their lead to 34.
Anderson drives in baseline, finds Shorter. Shorter out, three-pointer, bang. Colby Martin with another three-pointer.
Nixon, I'm believing they'll try and hold the ball for as long as possible.
Yeah, doing a little bit of dribble handoffs, just trying to run this clock down. Brewer at the top, got a close by Shorter. Brewer driving in behind the back. He's back. Sides. Sides trying to shake his man. Sides driving in. Mid-range jumper off back rim. Rebound Meisner. And it will go out of bounds. Bit of a bad pass from Meisner. But Nixa with a healthy lead. This clock will run out. And it was honestly, it looked like Carl Junction was trying to make a comeback into that half. Nixa came out firing really hot, played good defense, and just got, stole this one away from him, ran away with it.
Yeah, and it was a track match all game, so.
And that will be, your score will be 74-43 at the end of this Nixa versus Carl Junction junior varsity game. Stick around as the varsity game between Nixa and Carl Junction will be next, and we'll be back.
Folks, number 29, Emma Lee! Off and just short, but Evan gets the rebound, puts it up, no good. One more try off the glass, and it is good.
Let's go.
Lawler kicks it off for the first points.
Evan Nail pointing to the crowd.
And here comes Nate Cummings, the point guard up the court. Cummings passes it off. Shot. So close.
Then just a bit right. Like you said, the best game of the night. I agree.
I mean, Eric described it perfectly. It's the most smiles you'll see on the court tonight.
They all get to play the sport that they love.
Here comes India driving in. They're leading her towards the basket. On the block. Takes her time, losing control of it, but Coach Blantz is there to help out. Granny style, and it goes in! The granny style shot.
India banks it in. The granny shot.
Oh, they're pushing up court. Oh, fade away. Boom!
Smooth. Smooth fadeaway jumper, Jordan Davis.
White team playing some tough defenses. Number 28 goes in, the shot's up, and just short. Another shot's away, and it's good.
You can see the celebration.
Ethan hits it. Woo. Oh, Stryker for three. Oh. Well, kept alive by Lawler, a little tiptoe on the sideline.
I know, when I'm before the games, Evan practices that shot.
Oh. He made it. He's made it before.
Yeah,
he made
he
it
can
a lot.
Make it.
The shot's away and just right. Gets her own rebound. Up again, just right. Pass it off. Shot off the glass. Oh, rolls in and out. White team takes it back. Jordan pushes it up court. Looks up for Stryker. What a pass! Reverse layup.
Oh my goodness!
What a Jordan to Alex, the connection.
What a pass up the court. The court vision. It's the reverse layup. Showing off to the crowd a bit with that celebration.
Shot off the glass and it's good.
Nate Cummings takes the ball up the court.
I want to see Nate take a three. Oh,
no.
Shoot it, but falls short. Rebound, Evan. He passes it off. Here's India to bring it up with 2 minutes and 30 seconds left.
Yeah, going inside. A little bit of help from her teammates.
Takes a step back. Shots away and just short. Granny style again and just misses it. White team will push it back up. We go coast to coast. Shot falls just short, hits off the hands, but gets his own rebound one more time. Off the back iron. And Alex passes it back in to Stephanie.
Up.
Jump shots off the glass and it's good. And Booting's putting up a dominant performance.
Yeah.
But here comes Alex, a three-pointer off the glass, no good. Fade away, also no good. Rebound, Evan.
Ashlyn going inside. Off the glass.
One more try it. Ooh, rolls it in out.
1 minute, athletes. You have 1 minute.
Pushing up.
Stryker. Top of the key. Three. Oh, almost goes. Rebound, Evan. Now it's over to India with 44 seconds left. India passes it off. Shot is up and it's good. Now the ball starts up to Evan up court. He grabs it in the corner. 3-point shot, Evan. Oh, my bad, Alex. Now Evan will push it up court with 19 seconds.
Evan dishes it inside.
Shot's up and it's good. 10 seconds left. Here's Alex. Chew some clock off. 3-point shot, it's good! Alex!
Bang.
Right before the buzzer, and everybody's going crazy. Big 3-pointer from Alex.
What a shot from Alex.
That's every year Alex does it.
He's a lights out shooter.
Oh yeah. And it's always a great time. Thank you to Champion of Athletes for having this game every year. And Coach Blancett, we'll be back here shortly for the varsity contest between Carl Junction and the Knicks Eagles. We'll be back. We are live from Eagles Fieldhouse in Nixon, Missouri. I'm Brady Retone alongside my partner, Ryan Swanson. Ryan, how you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good. I mean, we've been off for 5 days, so I haven't had to go to school in a while, but I'm glad to be back in Eagle Fieldhouse. I'm excited for a game of basketball.
So are Mites. Eagles, and they will kick off their COC conference play against the Carl Junction Bulldogs. The Eagles have won 4 straight COC titles and look to continue the pure dominance they've had for so many years, because it's been, I mean, I think the last time they lost was 2019 against Ozark, and they still were COC champions.
Yeah, definitely have had a strong grip on this conference for a long time, and Carl Junction maybe want to have a chance to capitalize, especially with the Eagles' recent play, already 4 losses on the year, especially after a season where they didn't lose any in the regular season and ended up losing till the district championship. Definitely not something the Eagles were ready to have to go through. Well, definitely will be interesting.
And we talk about the Eagles' past, but really this past season has been not the best summer we've seen. We saw a lot of loss. I mean, last year we lost Cale Combs, probably the best basketball player to come through Nixa in Nixa basketball history. We lost, Noah Engelman. I mean, a big role player right there. And a lot of young guys are having to step up, and I mean, that's just kind of been the Eagles' struggle, is finding the big plays, the big moments coming from big players. And we saw that the other night when we played, I believe it was the 6th, we played Hickman, and we lost 69-61. And that was just more of a game of not having those big plays and big moments.
Yeah, and there's definitely been, the best way I describe it is growing pains. You're in an offense where most of the guys did not play varsity reps last year. A lot of the bench was not on varsity. They were JV last year. Sure, you got the four seniors on this team, and Garrett, and Devin, and Josh, and Kevon. But at the same time, there really isn't that much experience on the starting lineup in terms of varsity play. Those are the only, Devin, Garrett, and Josh are the only 3 that started last year. So it's definitely been a little bit hard to watch at
Devin
times.
Devin didn't even start.
That's right.
Devin was like the 6'7" man, but yeah, you said, I mean, only 2 starters returning. I mean,
he had a couple games he started if a guy was on injury, but it's just definitely been a little difficult for this Eagles team, and it's not what we were expecting at all for them coming into this season. It's been a lot of growing pains, but one thing also is that they're really, the identity of this team has really just been a question mark so far. I mean, the guys who are, there's not really the consistent guy putting up the same numbers every night. Sometimes it's the bench going out and getting the big surge of points to get in. Sometimes it's the starting unit. It's really been up and down this entire season. And Eagle fans are hopeful that they'll be able to ride out the storm and get ready for conference play and also playoffs, which really aren't that too far away. Hope they can get everything going by then. But there's been a lot of learning from this team, and I think they'll get better as the season goes on. But they have a couple of issues to fix, and conference play is very, very important, which each game in conference play can be competitive regardless of the record.
And coming up for the Eagles, well, we saw it was supposed to be yesterday against Parkview, got canceled due to weather. And Parkview, I don't even know if has a gym right now. I don't think they're playing.
They do not.
They're not playing home games right now. But that game got canceled and moved to February 12th. So if you were excited to watch Coach Simpson head back to the Eagles Fieldhouse, which I'm always excited to have Coach Simpson in the Eagles Fieldhouse, that game got moved to the 12th of February. And then coming up will be the NIT, one of the most competitive tournaments in the area besides, I mean, Blue and Gold and TOC. I mean, it's always a good tournament. I feel like that championship game is very competitive. This year it's loaded. Troy comes back. New Madrid comes back. Jadis Jones of New Madrid looks better than ever. I mean, I watched him play. He's a stud. I mean, the tournament's loaded this year. So I'm excited for that coming up. But tonight we have a matchup between the Bulldogs and the Eagles. The Bulldogs having a iffy start to the season, coming out 7-6 after coming off a win against Colligan High School, 51-43, and I believe they took 5th in the Kamakowski Classic. They lost to Hal, game number 1, 81-51, and then lost to Webb City, 65-49, and then topped off Neosho, 58-37. So I'm excited for this matchup tonight. We have a minute until tip-off. We're going to send it down to Eric Michelle for starting lineups and national anthem. We'll be back after this short break, brought to you by Central Gas and Propane.
varsity action. On Tuesday night, I hope you're ready to watch some great basketball action tonight. But folks, before we shoot a shot or bounce a ball, we, here at Nixa High School, we believe that we live in the greatest country on earth. We certainly feel it as an honor to truly cherish the moments when we are called upon to share our patriotism. For all of the veterans attending this event, thank you. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your sacrifice and proverbial hats off to you and your families for the price that you paid so we would be free. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please stand, gentlemen, for new color. Place your hands over your hearts for playing of not yours or not mine, but it's our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we
way too far, and at the end of one, it's been the Garrett Hines Show, folks. 30-9, the Eagles lead. We'll be back after this short break brought to you by Central Gas and Propane. And we are back for the second quarter. And folks, we apologize for the technical difficulties. We actually lost power on everything in the middle of a hype video. So I really don't know what happened completely. But we might have the first quarter on stream later. But if you miss anything, Garrett Hines had 19 points in the first. So it was a very impressive performance from Hines. 30-9 is the score. Here's Vedez. Picks up his dribble, looks inside. Now Edcott over Combs, can't finish, rebound by Garrett Hines.
And Garrett also has 5 made threes already on the night, 15
And now
that.
Combs for 3, no good. We didn't see Combs at all in the first quarter. Now pushing it up court, here's Paint. Floater, charge taken by Bryce Foster. And I think we saw a little sigh of relief there when he took it, because I think he got a little tense thinking there might be a block.
A little bit, definitely. Could have gone either way on that type of call. Definitely he sold it, but not all the way. Got the call, though. Free possession for the Eagles coming up.
Here's Meltebarger. Swinging around. Now Hines. Back to Meltebarger. Here's Vincent. 3-point shot fired away. No good off the back iron. Grabbing the rebound there will be Vedez. Vedez cutting through it, and Vincent wrapping him up and tackling him there.
Once again, try to go back to Friday Night Lights for a little bit. I mean, I'm no expert, but I'm pretty sure you can't tackle in basketball.
No. Here's Holcutt setting up the Bulldogs offense. Kicking it out, coming off the screen. 3-point shot from Edgut, no good. Rebound, Hines. Hines hands it off. Here's Meltebarger over Combs. One more time, Foster. 3-point shot, no good. Rebound, Meltebarger. He slides inside and lays that one off the glass. 4-2, Lane Meltebarger.
Taking almost a minute. A little bit over a minute and a half to get the first point to the second quarter after they put up 30 in the first.
Shot no good, poked free. Foul will be called.
Combs had a nice block right there on number 30, Aiden Beckner. Sorry, stumbled over my words there for me, Aiden Beckner. Fortunately, Eagles weren't able to grab the rebound and drew the foul. Carl Junction, chance getting double digits.
Free throw away, and it will roll in. First points of the night for Edcott. See McAfee check into the game alongside Jet Mills. Edcott's second free throw will roll in. 32-11 as we just got our scoreboard up, I believe. Here's Meltebarger. Top of the key. Back Meltebarger. Inside. Floating, fading away. What a shot coming from Garrett Hines. 21 points on the night.
Yeah, keep feeding him the rock. He's not missing a shot. Don't even think about putting him on the bench right now. Let him go.
Now driving through the lane. Here's Holcutt. 3-point shot. Bingo. 3-point. Sidestep three-pointer, no good. Coming from behind, he misses his first three of the night. Jump ball. A jump ball is going to be called.
What?
I was a little confused there, too.
I mean, it didn't look like
the Eagles have six on the court. The Eagles have six on the court. And Hines will check out for the first time. And what a performance coming in the first 12 minutes of the game coming from Garrett Hines. 21 points, a couple rebounds on the day, and it's a turnover. Here's Mills. McKnight driving through, blocked off the backboard, but be fouled first by Jace Combs.
Jace tried to poke it from behind, just got a little bit of his arm there. As McKnight threw that off the backboard, great block, but to no avail. And Hines getting a little bit of an ovation from the fans behind the Knicks bench as he went off. First free throw, no good.
Second free throw will fall. Cross-court pass, Melta Barter. One more time, Vincent inside. Cantwell, he'll lay it off the glass. It is good.
And slowly, with how well the Eagles have been shooting, I mean, let me rephrase, how well Garrett Hines has been shooting, Carl Junction slowly has been drifting more to the perimeter of the court and around the arc and just left the lane open for Cantwell, able to get one-on-one and an easy layup down low.
Three-point shot fired away from Jet Holtcutt, and it is good. The Eagles try to answer back fast, can't. We're going to see Peters check back in the game for Melta Barter. The Eagles lead by 18, 36 to 18. Here's Jet Mills. Pass on over, Wyatt McAfee. Back out. Edcott. Here's Vedettes. McAfee set up the offense. Picks up his dribble. Hands it back off. Mills fighting through the screen. Will be Combs. I believe they're going to call a foul on Jace Combs.
That's his second on the night. As Hines and Kemp get back in. Garrett did not get a long break at all. Blanton said get back out there after about a minute or two of rest. I mean, he's got 21.
How many threes does he have?
Five.
Five three-pointers so far. In the corner, Hines. Three-point shot. No good. Rebound McKnight, but he'll be fouled hard, soaring through the air.
Well, because he's got five for sure. That's 15. And he's got three of those fadeaway mid-range shots, so yeah.
No, it hits four because he had the and one. Or he had, he had a layup.
Oh, you're right.
I don't know. We're going to have to go check at halftime. I believe
it's four or five.
Here's Hines back off inside. Peters fading away, and it is good. I mean, Hines and Peters' jump shot, like the mid-range shot, is beautiful. Everything about it is just so smooth.
When they're hitting it, it's impossible to guard. Both of them standing at 6'3", 6'4"-ish. When they go up with it, it's impossible to block.
Shot blocked by Peters. My goodness. Speaking of the length there.
Speaking of block shots right there, Peters sent that to the cheerleaders, but Garrett and Josh currently have 31 combined points.
21 coming from Garrett and 10 coming from Josh.
So 31 of the 38 points of Knicks have come from the two seniors of Josh and Garrett.
A little thread the needle there, but can't finish. McKnight will grab his own board. Getting absolute maul, fading away, and it's off the glass. And one, Adam McKnight.
After his last game with that head injury, getting his first points back here in the second quarter.
That was very scary.
Mm-hmm. Definitely a scary
It's definitely good to see him back.
Still running and chasing boards and diving out of bounds as usual, so it's good to see him back.
He converts on the end one. He has three on the day. The Eagles lead 41-18. Hole cut three, no good. Rebound, Peters. Here's Hines back off Kemp in the corner, soaring through the air. McKnight. Cross court pass, Kemp inside Cantwell. One more time, Peters, the ball movement from the Eagles. Works out well. Ends with the Josh Peters layup.
And the way their 2-3 defense is working is when they shift, when the whole area shifts, there's a lane that opens up for a quick period of time. Peters saw it and just cut straight in, untouched going inside, and defense was too late to catch up.
Get the roll in there is Quinn Kennedy. Cross court pass, Hines, Peters. Back off McKnight, 226. McKnight finding a hole, back out. 3-point shot, Kemp, no good. Rebound, Cantwell. To Peters fading away, and he'll lay that in with one hand. Pass inside. Here's Holcutt. 3-point shot away, Edcott, no good. McKnight will push it up court to Kemp. Thread the needle one more time. 3-point shot is good. Garrett Hines, 24 points.
Keep feeding him the ball. Wow.
I mean, this has been an impressive performance.
I'm at a loss for words. 24 in the first half so far.
He must have ate his Wheaties this morning. Here's Kennedy blocked by McKnight, but a foul will be called first.
Might have gotten a little Michael Jordan special stuff in the locker room.
Maybe it was no school.
Maybe.
I have a grand idea, Ryan.
You have a grand idea?
Every day there's a basketball game, we cancel school.
I mean, I'm not complaining.
We would like to take this second to thank our sponsors. First off, we'd like to thank the Nixa Community Foundation. Thank you guys for our studio camera grant and your continued support for the Nixa Live student production. If you would like to donate, go to cfozarks.org and search for the Nixa Community Foundation. Thank you for your guys' endless support. We'll be back after this short break, brought to you by Knight Heating and Air. It'll be Quinn Kennedy at the line to shoot two after the second Bulldogs timeout. First shot's fired away, and it is good. Second shot from Kennedy will also go. Here's Kemp to bring it up court over Hines. 3-point shots away, no good. Tolcutt's gonna push it up court, hands it off Payne. Now in the hands of Videz. Payne in the corner, Holcutt. Videz throws it into the corner, double team brought on, back to Videz, one more time, Holcutt. We're under the minute mark here in the second quarter. Videz, deep 3-point shot, rolls in and out. Fighting for the board will be McKnight. He'll keep it alive in the corner, pushing it up court. Now he finds a hole, driving the lane, fading away, can't finish. Takes a very, very hard body there. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
He had every intention of getting that to the rim, maybe try and go for something crazy there. Absolutely mug though, going to the rim.
First free throw won't go.
I don't think any time McKnight's going to take a fall, then that not most of the fans are going to worry every time he takes a fall for the next little couple of games.
Yeah, I definitely will.
I definitely did on that last one, even though it wasn't
I know
the worst one.
I know his parents will, and I know Miss Frederick will. She talked to me after the game, and she was like, I like gasped, I'm like, oh my gosh. And then he got up, and I was like, was able to breathe a tad bit. Here's Videz. Over paint, back to Videz. Cross court pass, and it'll be tipped out of bounds. Looking for Belcher there.
29.7 left. I'm assuming Blant's just going to hold it.
Who do you think is going to take the last shot here?
I feel like this
I'm hoping it's Garrett Hines.
This is
really hoping it's a Garrett Hines three-pointer. Here's Peters.
Throw a brain
back
scratcher.
To Hines. Kip lobbed to Peters. A little too far, but he'll lay it in. Poked free there by Kip, and it will go off the face of Adam McKnight.
Man, Adam's getting beat up.
I know.
He gets beat up every game.
12 seconds left. In the corner, Videz three-pointer, no good. Kept alive, thrown across and out of bounds as time expires. So 49-22 will be the score here going in the half. It's been a dominant show from the Eagles, and it's been more of a dominant show from Garrett Hines. 24 first half points. So we'll be back after this short break brought to you by Scooter's Coffee. Scooting around on around for amazing people, amazing drinks, and amazingly fast. We'll be back after this short break.
Teacher asking me, what do you want to be when you grow up? And I said, I want to be a teacher or a nurse. I think if we instill these things in our kids, even at the age of 7 and 8 years old, they're like, hey, I love what the firefighter's doing. I want to be a hero.
And it helps them to have more appreciation for their community, because I think they hear about community helpers even all the way from kindergarten, but actually seeing them and meeting them in person and hearing directly from that source is a much bigger difference and impact.
I've been with NICS in 9 years, and I mean, we do this every year, almost all the elementary schools, everything. We get in there and visit. The message is always the same. You know, we want you to be safe and keep your friends and family and neighbors safe.
Get down whenever there's a fire and get out. He said, whenever your clothes is on fire, you should stop, drop, and roll.
For the kids to see the mayor, you know, they looked at him as a presidential candidate, and he was a big deal. And a lot of them were coming back to our classroom and saying, you know, I would like to be a mayor, or I'd like to be the president someday. And for them to understand that there are different positions besides a firefighter and a librarian that helps run our community.
And I don't think they really hear about that role as much in school. We're just very used to talking about those who go and save lives, which is definitely needing to be talked about. But I don't think we really talk about our roles in the government as much with kids.
We like for the kids and their parents to have a plan. If an incident does happen in their home, for those kids to have a meeting place, know where they're going, and that way parents can get there and have an accountability of those kids so they can let us know as we come up that, you know, we have everybody, everybody's out. Having two ways out of your room, you know, more than one exit, the front end one is, don't mess with that stuff to begin with. Be cautious, help your parents. You know, your parents get busy and forget there's a candle burning.
You know, I think that's what it takes, is the community to get involved in the schools and the schools to get involved in the communities. And that's what makes us one big happy family. And so that's what I felt like on Community Day, is that we were one big happy family working together.
It's like they just look up to you going in, and they know your name, and they ask you questions, ask you permission to do things. It almost feels like rewarding, and like you're making an impact on these kids' lives, and it's a great feeling.
Kids really need to know that your food just doesn't show up. There's so much time and effort that farmers put into it for it to be there, and so you're able to be healthy and get the nutrition that you need.
I think they're doing amazing. I was here the first week, and then I just pop in randomly, and I kind of let them take charge. These three, and there's three to four others that kind of help teach when they can, but they help prepare the lessons. I kind of store the stuff and tell them what they need.
And we are back live after the break, brought to you by Austin Orthodontics. And it is a kind of a barn burner so far. We've seen some excitement, though, coming from Josh Peters, a big dunk. But the main excitement, I'd like to say, is the 5 3-point performance coming from Garrett Hines, lighting it up on fire.
Definitely. And one thing that really we expected to see at the start of the season is Josh and Garrett really being the main ways of scoring from this team. It's been a little up and down. Garrett's had some good games. Josh had some good games. They both had their bad ones. But tonight, 38 points between the two of them. And Garrett's having the best night of his season and maybe even his career with 24 in the first half. Eagles up big, and it's been going every way for the Eagles.
And it's the more impressive part has been they haven't shot this well in so long. And I mean, they have lost two straight in Eagles Fieldhouse. I don't remember the last time that's happened. I don't know if that's happened when I've been alive, to be honest with you, Ryan. You don't see an Eagles team lose two straight at home. This place is always a hostile place to play, and seeing them lose two has just been kind of crazy, in my opinion.
It definitely has, and in terms of actual home games, the Eagles haven't won a home game this year. All of the games they've won have been in a tournament setting. They have no true road or home game the Eagles have won this year. But right now, looking good so far, have a really good chance to get their first win at home of the year.
Three-point shot, no good, rebound by Peters. Still push it up court. He has 14 on the night. In the quarter, Kemp, pass slammed into the ground there. And through the lane, it is good.
Yeah, I agree with you on that one. Might have been a travel there, but
I was thinking it was. He took like six steps there, to be honest.
Throw still up 25.
Here's Cantwell in the paint, spinning through, loses control, keeps it inbounds, but kept alive. Throwing it up court here is Valdez, and it is good for two. Pass inside to Cantwell, and it is good. Trap in the corner, now cutting through the lane. Count it. It's Payne. Payne. Here's McKnight, looks inside. Cantwell lays it in for two. I think he's going to throw it down for a minute.
I did too. I was really hoping he would.
He got the height for it.
Just a little bit.
Paint controls it over to Holcutt. The Eagles sit back in the 2-3 zone. Now cutting to the hoop, fading away. Jump shot, no good. It will stay Bulldogs basketball.
I know you're down a ton, but maybe not the smartest shot to take in that situation. Kemp's on you the whole way through. You pull up with a three, get a chance at it, but definitely not the best shot on the floor.
In the corner, back to the top, here's Edcott. Lose control of the ball there. Shot blocked by Cantwell. Poked free. And now fighting for the board. Foul's going to be called first.
Now here's a stat for you. The last time the Eagles won a true home game at Eagle Fieldhouse, you're going to have to go back to February 23rd of 2023, where they beat Neosho 71-35.
That game was, I mean, I believe it was senior night, but it was also the first coach, I believe, to go undefeated in Knicks history as their first year. Fading away will be Peters. Nylon.
And again, that mid-range shot is so hard to defend when Garrett and Josh are hitting it consistently.
Foul's going to be called on the ground. He charged to the Eagles. Devin Kemp. Here's Holcutt. Controls a dribble. Now hesitating, fading away. What a shot, Jet Holcutt. 3-point shot from Peters finds the bottom of the net.
And right now, Blancett and the Eagles are just picking on him in the transition. They're not getting back in time, the Bulldogs, and they're just slinging it down to Cantwell, to Peters, or to Hines, and they're just letting him rip from deep or inside the lane.
Now falling on the ground, 3-point shots away, no good. Foul will be called inside on Adam McKnight.
I do need to double check this. Isn't it 30 for Turbo Clock?
It is 30 for Turbo Clock.
I was going to say, because we're at 28. Happened in the JV game, so I had to make sure I knew my high school basketball rules.
Thrown to the backcourt, and it is grabbed by Holcutt. Three-point shot is away, and it is good. Coming from Wyatt McAfee.
I mean, he just saw the amount of space he had. Saw it was Cantwell in front of him. Just, all right, screw it. Took the shot. Good three-point bucket for the Bulldogs.
Foul called there on the Bulldogs as cutting through the lane was Kemp. Charged to Jet Holcutt.
I mean, if you didn't foul Kemp there, he was going to make that shot regardless. So good at driving into the lane is Devin Kemp. Hines hop step in the lane.
Can't finish. It's pushed up court. Now spinning through the lane, poked free. Here's Edcott. Driving on McKnight, kicks it out. 3-point shots fired away. No good. Rebound, McKnight. Now here's Peters driving through the lane. Reverse lay will go.
And Josh catching up to Garrett as he's got 21. He's only three behind. We're going to get a whole new five for the Eagles. All went to the scorer's table.
Now controlling the ball at the top of the key will be Pate. three-point shot is away, and it is good. Jet Holcutt, his 13th of the day.
And one of the few bright spots of this Bulldogs team this game is their three-point shooting has been doing pretty well at times.
Now jab step and go. Cantwell can't finish. Fighting for will be McKnight. He'll be charged with the foul. His third, but we'll see five new Eagles check into the game here in the third quarter and likely the end of the starters. And we were really hoping for a three-point record coming from Hines, but we won't see it. So it's sitting at eight, tied between Reuter and Wofford. Passed off, here's Holcutt, guarded by Combs. Hands it back off, now driving through the lane, off the glass, no good. Flint over to Vincent. In the corner, Melta Barger, corner three, no good. Rebound by Paint, he'll push it up court. Kept alive by Mills. Now Holcutt's three-point shot is away. No good. Paint over Edcott. Now Mills. Back over. Here's Beckner. Poked free there. Now Flint tries to go behind his back and throws it off the brand new video scores table.
I don't think Burns is too happy with the basketball hitting his new scoreboard.
I don't think Mr. Clark's too happy with the basketball being thrown off the scoreboard.
I don't think anybody's
happy with it. to 36 is your score with a minute 53 left on the clock.
At least this year we haven't had any people dive over our desk yet.
Not yet.
Keyword yet.
Hopping through the lane as Mills passes it off, but he fouled hard by Randy Flint.
Now that you said that, I feel like there was multiple times where basketball was thrown right at our desk. Multiple times last year.
It happened a lot.
It hasn't happened once this year.
We had a girl during the pink and white go flying into the table and almost hit Brady Richard. That's been it.
I haven't had to duck yet, hallelujah.
Second free throw is away, and it is good. Hands it off, Combs. Now Vincent. Vincent to Kevon Flint. Now he'll drive to the hoop, poked free there. Regained possession by the Bulldogs. Here's Mills, left open for three. It is good.
Way too much space to operate, even with the hesitation from Jet Mills to take that shot. He pulls it and absolutely drills it.
Kevon Flint over to Vincent. Deep shot from Combs. Way off, fighting for it, kept alive. Actually, he'll be called out of bounds there. Was Melta Barger with 49.3 seconds left on the clock.
Now, I'm not the smartest guy in the world, Brad, but Nixon has four fouls and yet the double bonus is up. I don't think that's how that works.
What do you mean?
Like, look at the scoreboard. CJ has the double bonus.
Saying next foul. They put it up like on the fourth foul every time, saying because the next foul. They're in the double bonus. Because technically they're in the double bonus right now. Because the next foul they have, they'll shoot free throws.
I've never seen it done like that. Normally they don't
put
it up
until
5.
That's how everybody does it.
No shot.
I swear to you, Ryan.
I don't think that's true.
Is
I
it
think
only
you're
here?
Just crazy.
Burns is shaking his head. No, it's only here. Okay.
I was going to
Yeah.
I've even noticed that here either. I don't know if it was just the scoreboard was wrong, if I was wrong.
I thought everybody did it that way.
I didn't even know anyone did it that way. I've done this for 3 years and haven't noticed that. That tells
you
anything.
I guess it's only done at Nixa. But they usually put up the double bonus. And Flint gets bodied hard there going to the hoop. We're going to line two, shoot two.
This is my second year doing this with you, and I still haven't noticed that, so I don't think anyone's having any issues with it, so just thought what I had.
It's okay. Flint's first one is good.
And drills the second one.
Here's Holcutt guarded tightly by Flint. Lucas trolled the ball in. It will be a backcourt violation as he dribbled it off of his foot. Wasn't poked for you. Dribbled off the foot, and with 7.6 seconds left on the clock, it'll be Eagles basketball. Deep pass to Randy Flint is pressed up. Is Jet Holcutt. 3 seconds left at the buzzer. Setback three is good, Randy Flint. 65-40, the Eagles lead, and we will see almost all of the starters check back in. It'll be Foster, McKnight, Cantwell, Peters, and Hines. We'll take a short break brought to you by Central Gas and Propane. And we are back for the fourth quarter. Here's Foster. .740. Now over McKnight. Inside to Cantwell. Puts a dribble on the ground off the glass, and it is good for two, Jackson Cantwell.
We've said it a couple times here, but Cantwell's gotten way better at his moves inside the post.
His feet have gotten quicker. And I think that's definitely been the biggest. Shots blocked there by Cantwell. Rebound by Foster, pushed up court. Here's McKnight driving through the lane. Jump step, no good. Second chance is good. His sixth point of the night. Here's Videz. Hands it off, shot blocked. Rebound by Cantwell. Now driving through the lane will be Foster. Be poked free, Bulldogs basketball.
You know, after the Hickman game and this being the game right before the NIT for the Knicks Eagles, this is a very big statement win. Going into obviously NIT and then right after that conference play. If they're able to hold on.
For sure. The Eagles lead by 29 with 6:30 on the clock. Now driving baseline. Step through, throws it up. Can't finish, rebound by McKnight. Here's Peters, 3-point shot is good. It's 24. It's 24 and 24 coming from Hines and Peters. Control the ball and falling on it. We the Bulldogs now driving baseline. Holcutt brings it back out, coming off the screen. jumper in the face of Jackson Cantwell will go.
And Jet Hocutt's been having himself an night. I mean, obviously, it's been a little shadowed by Peters and Hines and the Eagles right now, but he's got 15 on the night. He's been having a good game.
See, five new Bulldogs and four new Eagles come in. The clock should be running here.
Now it should be with time stopping and Eagles 30-point lead. Or is it just between quarters? I don't know if it's just between quarters. You might need our unofficial but official rules analyst, Jordan Burns, to give us a statement on that.
It should be right now.
I don't know if he heard me up there, but I do kind of want to figure this out.
Traveling violation will be called. It'll be Eagles basketball. Here's Flint. Driving to the hoop, hands it off. Off the glass, it is good. Lane Meltebarger coming from Kevon Flint. Here's Mills in the corner. Taken away by Flint. Now driving baseline, off the glass, it is good. Now Mills driving through, kicks it back out. Now Mills picks up his dribble. Taken away by Flint. Through contact, gets hammered. He'll go to line two, shoot two.
I mean, absolutely mugged going up. Yeah, completely checked going up. Try and get that layup in, and you would be right, Mr. Retone. It is running clock.
We'll see Kevon Lewis head to the scores table. First free throw is no good. Kevon Flint checks out of the game. Second free throw is also good. Swung around the perimeter. Now driving to the hoop. What a finish coming from Jet Mills. Now Randy Flint over Lewis. Driving to the hoop, back off Meltebarger. Three-point shot from Meltebarger is good.
Meltebarger for three.
Stay tuned, folks, for after we're going to have our Central Gas and Propane Player of the Game, Garrett Hines. Three-point shot is away. No good from Lewis as he had 19 first-quarter points. Flint and Combs head to the scores table for the Eagles. The Eagles lead 82-44.
And one thing that's very exciting to see for this Knicks Eagles team from tonight is the three-point shooting looked probably the best it's been all year.
For sure. And it's been, I mean, talented up. I mean, we've been probably the worst three-point shooting team we've seen in a while. I mean, usually when you look at the Eagles, you're like, they're going to light up from beyond the arc. And it just wasn't that way to start the season off, and then it got progressively better and better, and now it's probably been the best. It's definitely been over 50%.
I know we say this in the pregame show, but we've also stated this at the beginning of the season that was going to happen, which were the growing pains. Hopefully this is going to be a sign that maybe we're out of those and maybe that the Eagles are going to start playing better and better as the rest of the season goes on, getting into conference play and then district play. I mean, it definitely will be interesting tonight, a very huge night for the Eagles.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the floor, Greg Hayes.
Minute 18, the Eagles leading 82-46. In the corner, Lewis. Jab step, bringing it back out. Step back three from Lewis, no good. Poked back out to Lewis. He'll drive to the lane. Tuck and roll. What a finish coming from Kevon Lewis. Now spinning through. Poked free there by Combs. So he'll take it to the hoop. Euro step. And we'll lay it in for two. Controlling it here is Hayes over Swartz. Back up shorter. 10 seconds on the clock. Back to Swartz. Shot blocked. And now with 6 seconds left, the Eagles will hold it out and get their first home victory of the year after dropping two this year. It's going to be a big win, 86-46. Folks, stay tuned. We're at Darren Hines for our post-game interview. We'll be back.
Wow, you guys have
and
to wear this.
We are back with our Central Gas and Propane player of the game, Garrett Hines. Garrett, great game tonight.
Should I hear something in here?
Yeah, you're supposed to hear yourself talk.
I don't hear nothing.
Oh, really? Here, hold on, wait. How about try now?
Hello? I don't.
We can hear you.
Oh, can you hear us now? All right, we had some technical difficulties real quick. Garrett, you had 19 in the first quarter, one of your best performances this year. I mean, was it just kind of the feel coming in today? How was that?
Yeah, I mean, I just came out like I do every game, I guess, and I just had the hot hand today. So
we saw some shooting struggles start at the beginning of the year. How have you kind of overcame those coming into, like, tonight?
Yeah, I mean, I think at the beginning of the year, you know, I'm not getting those passes I was from Kale last year. I mean, he was just getting in the lane, kicking out to me and Josh for wide open threes. So both me and Josh have kind of struggled a little bit at the beginning of the year, but I think we're starting to find our groove now, and we should be able to carry that on throughout the rest of the season.
After falling to Hickman and, of course, Kickapoo and Central, those really close games, what were Coach Blancett's talks in the locker room and everything coming out of those?
Yeah, I mean, he mainly just said we got to stick together. We had watched film after every one of those losses, and I think we got better from it. We practiced the stuff we were messing up on and whatnot. Mm-hmm. So I think we've learned from it, and it's going to make us better in the future.
All right, Gary, you got obviously NIT conference play and all of that stuff coming up. Couple of really big opponents, especially after the Central and Kickapoo games. What's really just the focus to stay focused, especially after some of those last second losses that we've had this year?
Yeah, I mean, I know for myself, I'm just going to try to keep coming out here every night and playing hard, just max effort. And for the team, it's just keep playing together, keep finding the open man, and yeah, just keep playing hard.
All right, that's all I got.
Thank you, Garrett. Good game tonight.
Appreciate it.
86-46 was your score here at Eagles Fieldhouse. From Ryan Swanson, I'm Brady Retone, signing off.
I've got 3 meetings, 4 time zones, first one starts. 60 seconds. Can you fix my power?